Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will.
Yes,
hot
you will.
Teacher.
Gross.
Really?
You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked to him in a while.
Now that is a great plan.
By the way, in case you guys are wondering
Let's see if I can find out where Nathan is.
In case you guys are wondering what all the noise was, I was pouring more ginger ale for myself. I don't
want
to go that way.
I don't want to go that way.
Just being thorough.
Principal Wells was so loaded the other night here.
He sure was.
Poor Daniel. Looks like he needs a hug.
I don't even remember him.
Hey, Daniel. You look bummed out. Are you alright?
Hola, Max. I just figured out that my photos basically suck. I'm a wannabe artist.
Don't give up.
Don't give up that easy. Just stay away from your sketchbook for a while. You need to keep taking the shot, as Mr. Jefferson says.
Stay away from my sketchbook? You don't know me, Max. That's like you staying away from your camera. I think I'll just sit here bummed out, thanks.
Damn, all right.
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still bumming. I'll talk to you later when I'm not so pathetic.
Justin, it's been so long since I've seen you.
Because you're way too cool for us now, Chloe.
Way too much shit going on, man.
Try going to Blackwell. Insane.
So I hear.
Any word at all on Rachel?
Dude, I wish. I'm working on it.
I miss her laugh when I fell off my board.
She was probably high.
Yeah, she had the sick nugs.
True dat. Okay, I have to bounce.
Come hang with us at the park sometime.
Hey, is it 420 yet?
420 yet?
Chloe fits in so easy with Justin.
Let me know when you found something.
Whoa, watch it.
Whew. Good thing I didn't let Chloe take that money from Principal Wells.
Oh, good. So it really was a bona fide handicapped fund. Accessibility upgrades. Well, so just in case she does end up in a wheelchair. well, she can't go back here anyway, right? Alyssa, why you play hard to get when you're already hard to want? Oh, mean. Erase. Right over.
Sweet Kate.
Hmm. We barely knew her, though.
Enjoy the big game, Zachary. I hope it's not the last.
Hmm. There's a totem doing. Oh, we can take a picture here.
Okay, where did these rocks come from?
Hmm.
This is too Blair Witch for me.
You really?
One photo. For posterity.
Are the rocks gonna start doing things weird now? Weird things? Wait till the game. Wow, that thing's going off far.
I don't think the Tobanga will ever give up any secrets to us.
Does it have any secrets to tell?
That's so ironic that Warren asked Max to the drive-in.
I'm Max. Why is that ironic?
Brooke doesn't look happy that I'm going ape with Warren.
It's not like I don't own all the original Apes films.
Hey, Brooke. How are you?
Considering what happened to Kate, I could be better. Are you okay?
Don't have an option to talk to her. Instead, we'll talk about Nathan.
I need to find Nathan. Have you seen him around?
Ask Warren. I mean, you're going to the movies with him and everything.
Come on, Brooke. Don't be that way. Nathan was suspended, but he should still be on campus.
Warren's not good enough for you? Okay. I saw Nathan pissed and walking off campus earlier. Good luck getting that date, Max.
Huh. Well, jealous. She likes Warren. Obviously.
I can't get my limited brain around that eclipse and the beached whales. I was hoping the science department had some ideas.
Warren and I are supposed to compare notes and theories this weekend.
Well, that makes sense.
That makes sense. Two big brains are better than one. Or mine.
We'd get the Nobel Prize if we could explain this phenomenon, but even Miss Grant has no clue.
How's your drone?
I might feel better taking your drone for a quick flight.
Miss Grant finally gave up and let me fly her again. But you're going to the drive-in with Warren, so you don't have time to fly my drone.
Really?
What?
I can't fly your drone because I'm going to see ape movies with Warren?
You are perceptive, Max. Now, excuse me. My drone needs me.
Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
That's so stupid. We're obviously not going to the movie right now, you jackass.
That's so ironic that Warren asked Max to the drive-in.
I'm standing right here, jerk.
Talk to you later, Max.
Is there any reason for us to rewind and talk to her? I don't think so. Can't go in here this time.
I had to clear away another batch of dead birds today. Sad.
Makes me mad. Climate change isn't real my ass.
I think everything is changing here.
As a scientist, I'm fascinated. As Michelle Grant, I'm very worried.
Arcadia Bay is scared too. Look at the weather. And the animals.
Not to mention poor Kate Marsh.
We all need to look out for each other these days.
That's so cool that they're talking and stuff. I like that.
That's cool to see that Samuel's not alone for once.
How are you doing, Max? Been a tough week. I know.
Yes, it has, Samuel. How are you?
Sad and confused, like everybody else in Arcadia Bay. You look like you have a lot of questions, too.
Yes, I have three of them. What do you think happened to the animals?
I definitely have questions about what's happening to the animals in Arcadia Bay.
Oh, many do. These poor creatures have no choice in what happens to them.
Something happened to squirrels, too? Well, it was beached whales.
How can anybody explain all those poor beached whales?
My dad was a fisherman, and he'd take me out to hear the whales sing. Now they just cry.
Aww. They're not alone.
They're not alone these days. I feel so powerless.
Oh, no. You're the opposite of powerless, Max.
You think so, Samuel?
You and Arcadia Bay are connected by time and tide. Huh. So, next time I have a question, I'm coming to you.
You know what? This is a case of intelligence versus wisdom. He knows things. Not from reading books or being smart, but he knows things.
Well, I'm glad to see your squirrels are still healthy and happy on the campus.
Me too. If something happened to them... Oh.
Not as long as you're here to take care of them, Samuel.
The only thing that calms them is food. Lots of food.
Huh.
Which reminds me that I have to feed them now.
Get that food in your belly.
Picture? No.
Sorry to bother you again, Samuel.
There's no bother here, Max.
Arcadia Bay.
I still have a million questions about what's happening to Arcadia Bay.
That must be why Miss Gant says you're one of her favorite students at Blackwell.
You know what happened to Rachel?
I keep thinking that Rachel Amber has a few answers. If we can find her.
If Rachel wants to be found.
You think she's alive?
Do you think she's alive?
She'll always be alive in our hearts. Sometimes, that's all we have left.
That's not what I meant.
Max, all I can tell you is to stay on your path and you'll find what you're looking for. Rachel Amber is waiting too.
Well. What do you know about the Vortex Club?
I'd rather be in her class than the Vortex Club.
Yes, you would. Rachel saw right through them.
She's not the only one.
Nobody should be trapped in the Vortex Club. Get out now, Max, while time is on your side.
What about that eclipse?
Even though Miss Grant likes me, I have zero science skills to explain that eclipse.
As I was just saying to her, that's because science has no explanation. No offense to Miss Grant here, but this is just the beginning.
Beginning of what?
Beginning of what?
Oh, I don't believe anything ever ends. Especially time. That's why I can sense something bigger is coming to Arcadia Bay. And Max, I don't like it at all.
More questions than answers.
Samuel is always here to talk.
What do you know about David?
Do you ever talk with David Madsen?
He talks to me. I listen.
That's how David operates.
He sees things, not people. But I think he sees you, Max.
Why?
Why do you say that?
Because you both see with cameras.
I think you have better vision than both of us.
No, Max. I just look at everything from a different angle.
Nathan?
Have you seen Nathan Prescott around?
That would be hard since he was suspended.
You don't sound sad about that.
You don't sound sad, Samuel.
Nathan hurts people. The end.
What do you really know about him?
Not enough to help you, Max. I truly wish I could. I see what you're doing.
And Kate.
Blackwell is so sad and quiet since Kate... isn't here anymore.
Yes. And you can tell that the campus is different now. And you reached out to her when everybody turned away.
Mm-hmm. destiny?
It could have gone either way. Samuel, do you think that we each have a destiny?
Yes, I do, Max. In many different lifetimes, of course. Kate Marsh believed in something different, so that's her destiny.
I believe you.
Kate just needed some more helpful spirits like her friend Max. I hope she finds them now.
I definitely have questions about what's happening to the animals in Arcadia Bay.
Oh, many do. These...
Didn't get to ask them about the birds.
What do you think about all those dying birds?
Samuel had to bury dozens near the Tabanga.
What happened?
What happened to them?
I would say the sky is too dirty for their wings, but something worse is in the air.
It's so ominous.
Unless it's fate, then it doesn't matter.
I'm sorry. I better get going now.
Now I see what's going on here. We're gonna have two very differing points of views. Wisdom and intelligence, like a spirituality, of belief, knowledge of the universe, yeah, two different ways. I don't know how to explain it really. It's more, not so much as spiritual, but he just knows things. Don't be dive bombing with this thing, because you're jealous about Warren.
Hello, Max.
Hello.
Thanks again for helping.
Mrs. Grant looks interested in whatever Samuel is saying.
Yeah, we're not even listening to her.
Good. Nathan is not around. I should go back to Chloe.
We're going to talk to her first.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Max, you always show up when I'm talking about you. I'm still bragging about you and the other students making Blackwell surveillance free.
Right on. Nathan?
I was looking for Nathan Prescott, and I thought he might be in your class.
Mr. Prescott has no class at all after his suspension. I didn't think you were friends.
Hell no.
Hell no. Sorry, Miss Grant.
You're an adult. You can swear, dammit. And I'm glad you did.
So, you haven't seen Nathan at all?
Let's just say I try not to, Max. But I did catch him storming off campus. After what happened this week, I hope you don't see him either. You're not the best student here, but you might be the wisest.
Hmm. Kate.
I don't think surveillance would have helped Kate Marsh.
Oh, Max. I'm so sorry you had to go through that. Kate. Sweetest student I've ever met at Blackwell. And they can be so cruel to each other. Do you need to talk to a counselor?
Blackwell needs help.
Blackwell Academy needs the help. There's something terrible going on here. You see it, right?
This week hasn't been Blackwell's finest hour. But me and some faculty members won't rest until all the students here feel safe. Not bullied.
Kate was drugged at the Vortex Club party and bullied by them until she ended up on the roof. How do you stop that?
Shut down that damn Vortex Club for a start.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mean to get riled up, but that party should have been postponed. It's extremely tasteless given what happened with Kate.
The Prescotts.
Do the Prescotts have anything to do with the Vortex Club? I mean, they don't get all their money from car washes.
No, they don't. But membership has its privileges. Especially when your father is Blackwell's biggest sponsor. This elitist nonsense has no place here.
You're right. I just wish this could be the school that I dreamed about before I came here.
I hear you, Max. I love seeing you and Warren and all my students at your best here. But you're all too young to be so cynical. But you truly give me hope.
In recent events.
I was hoping you could explain some of these crazy things happening in Arcadia Bay.
If I could,
I'd be collecting my Nobel Prize in Science today. I haven't been able to wrap my mind around that eclipse, much less the snow in Wales.
There must be a scientific explanation.
There
beyond science,
must
too.
Be a scientific explanation, right?
When my friends at NASA tell me they can't explain a solar eclipse without a single theory as to how or why, maybe it's time to get worried. Like they are.
I am worried about reality. I feel like it's changing right in front of us.
You and Samuel both. We were talking about that before you came over. Our planet is changing, but it's not mystic. It's erosion.
Hmm. Some kind of prophecy?
So, you don't think this could be some kind of prophecy or something?
Max, you know how fascinated I am by Arcadia Bay legends. But I haven't found any apocalyptic signs yet. Unless you count those end of the world posters. Unless you know something I don't.
Hmm. I know a little something about time travel.
What about wormholes and chaos theory? Like time travel stuff.
The only wormholes in Arcadia Bay are underground.
Huh.
And chaos theory is just that. But if this is about time travel, sign me up.
Would you really change time?
Not after reading that Bradbury story, A Sound of Thunder. I won't give it away, but it involves dinosaurs and butterflies. Time is like a thread, Max. One tug and it all can unravel.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant.
Yep.
I have to get going. I'll see you later.
It's always good talking to you, Max.
On that note...
Let's talk again soon, Max.
So, interestingly enough, I think that Samuel actually might know a little bit more about what's going on than our science teacher here. But,
I feel like the sky wants to yell at us.
Stuff you really can't put into words easily.
Two cute little squirrels posing for me? If you insist.
So I got two pictures. Of course, she was already upset I defended David, even though I still didn't like any of his surveillance bullshit. But it seems like he's trying to help, even though I'm not sure, really sure how. And I have to acknowledge I simply don't know what the hell he's up to. Not that it stopped me from busting out some of my patented ninja moves so I can get around him to grab some more of his secret X-Files. After we gathered our new info, like Halloween treats, I loved watching Chloe go into Sherlock mode while we examined all of our clues on her big old drawing board. Of course, we all know that she's more of a Dr. Watson, right? Elementary. Honestly, with all the impending doom and sadness, I felt so happy just to find myself back in action with my best friend and her butterfly blue hair. Hella yes. Oh, wow.
Eat up. Food is the universal language.
Hello, Max. Thanks again for helping me fight the power.
Fight the power. The boys' dormitories. Do they all go through maybe the different wings? This way is the boys and that way is the girls or something? Figured it'd be separate buildings.
Coast is clear. It would be so cool if you and me were going to school here together.
But now you can have Mr. Jefferson all to yourself.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell Ninja mode.